We're so glad to be with you at New Roads Online today. My name is Kathy O'Leary, and I serve on the team at New Roads. I want to share a few notes as we get started. First, we want to let you know that this Mass has been pre-recorded, but our chat is live, so be sure to say hello there. Our chat hosts are waiting to welcome you, answer any questions you may have, and help you feel connected as we worship together today. You can access our online chat at newroads.online.church during our 10 a.m. Sunday broadcast. Before we begin today, this is a great time to invite someone you know to join you for Church Online. You can text them the link or post it to your social media platform of choice. Also, if you're new here, maybe someone invited you or you came across us recently, we'd love to meet you. Just click on the I'm New button, either in Church Online or on our website. Let us know who you are and ask any questions you may have. We'd love to hear from you. We also want to help you keep up to date with everything going on at New Roads. So whether you're new here or you've been coming regularly or anything in between, be sure you're signed up for our email list. To join our email list, just text New Roads, all one word, to the number 84576. Again, text New Roads to the number 84576 to join our email list, and that way you won't miss a thing. And we do have a number of exciting things going on this fall. We're relaunching our kids' worship experiences in person, and we're making some significant upgrades to our worship space. For all the details, visit our website, newroadscatholic.org. You're also welcome to join us in person every Sunday at 10 a.m. Just visit our website for more information about Mass in person. It's now time to worship together. Thanks for being with us.
The same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Oh yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Oh yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley.
Oh, the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, friends, as we come together to celebrate the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. As we begin, let's pause for a moment to call to mind our need for God's love, mercy, healing, and peace. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you. We adore you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King. Oh God, Almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
It's time to hear God's word to us today. Now is a great time for all families with children to take advantage of our kids' videos online, where kids get to hear God's word applied to their age and stage of life. There are videos for preschoolers, elementary age kids, and preteens. You can set your kids up on another device to watch any of those videos right now at newroadscatholic.org/kids.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, "Let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us, for he is our God, and we are the people he shepherds.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your heart. If today you
today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massa in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my work.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder in every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet, but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask, but do not receive because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee, but he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him, and 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one such child as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thanks for joining us for the second week of a message series we're calling "I'm Fine." Actually, it's called "I'm Fine and Neither Are You." Because the truth is, no one is truly fine, not all the time. And certainly not all the time these days. And yet, "I'm fine" is the most common response to the most common question we're asked when we see someone, or meet someone, or greet someone on the street, or pick up the phone. "How are you?" "I'm fine." It's actually almost never my response, to be honest. I have a couple of standard responses, but my most common response to the question, "How are you?" is, "Never better." It's something my father used to say, and I've made it a habit. The thing is, people who know me know it's really an aspirational answer. Usually I say "never better" when I'm honestly not doing so great at all. So yeah, it's a little sarcastic, because usually the worse things are, the wider I smile and shake my head, "never better." No matter how we're really doing under the surface, "How are you?" doesn't usually lend itself to a more nuanced answer, especially in most of our interactions throughout the day, and that's fine. Reply how you wish to that standard question. But what we're looking at in this series is how we're really doing. What's underneath the surface? Sometimes we are fine, but oftentimes we're really not. No one's fine all the time. No one's fine all the time because life just isn't all fine. No matter how much we deny or deflect or minimize it, we all experience pain and loss in life. No one is immune from wounds in life. Physical, emotional, relational, mental, spiritual wounds are simply a reality. Loss is part of life, no matter what. And during the pandemic, I think we've just been stacking loss on top of loss on top of loss, individually and as a community, as a country, and as a human race. Sometimes seeing all of the pain in the world, and there is just so much of it on display lately, it can make us feel like, you know what? I can't complain. Compared to those people in that situation, I've got a lot to be grateful for. I'm fine. Certainly, we all have a lot to be grateful for. But the reality of our own pain and loss is not something we can or should deny or push to the side simply because someone else has more pain. It's like saying, "Well, yeah, I've got an infected cut, but that guy over there has two broken legs, so I'm just not going to deal with my own thing." Don't get me wrong. We should feel for that guy with two broken legs, but we should also deal with our own wounds. It turns out, when we deal with our own wounds, we're better able to bring healing to others. No matter who you are, no matter what family you were born into, no matter your career or stage of life, we all have wounds. Some of our wounds are shallow, others are deep, some are old and familiar, others are fresh and raw. There are those among us today struggling with physical pain. There are emotional wounds among us, trauma, heartbreak, betrayal, abandonment. There are the wounds that come from loss, the loss of a job, the loss of money, the loss of a loved one. We have self-inflicted wounds too, from our own failures and weaknesses. No matter the source of our wounds, we all have them. So the question is not whether you have wounds or not. The question becomes, what do you do with the wounds that you do have? How do you handle them? Last week, as we kicked off this series, we said it really comes down to two choices. We can deny, minimize, and numb our pain, or we can turn to God for healing. That sounds like an obvious choice. But we almost always make the first choice. In the moment, in the short term, it's a lot easier to deny, minimize, and numb our pain. Turning to God for healing? Well, that takes work. That takes surrender. That means acknowledging and embracing the pain. It's a big ask. But it's the direction we're seeking to move during these series. Because when we don't seek God's help with our pain, the consequences are significant. Last week we talked about what's at stake with this topic. When we don't deal with our pain, when we don't acknowledge our pain, when we don't bring it to God and allow Him to transform us through our pain, if we simply ignore it or deny it, we end up transmitting it. Our pain leaks because pain that has not been transformed gets transmitted. If we don't allow God to transform our pain, we will most assuredly transmit it.
usually to those closest to us, our family, our neighbors, our co-workers, our children. Well, this is exactly where we're picking up today. So much of our pain comes in our relationships. Not all of our pain is relational in nature, but pain, no matter its source, always ends up affecting our relationships. In the second reading from the letter of St. James, we hear this very relevant question. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? It's a good question, really. Why do people fight? Why are there wars and conflicts around the world, around our own dinner tables, in our text chains? What's the source of it all? Maybe it's a lack of communication. Maybe it's a lack of resources or a lack of boundaries. Maybe it comes from different values or different personality types. Well, James answers his question with another question. Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet, but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. By passions, James is referring to all the ways in which we want more. On the one hand, we can be loving and generous and kind, but the truth is, we're all divided. Because there is this thing in all of us that wants what we want, when we want it. We can be envious and selfish. There's conflict on the outside because there's a war on the inside. We're divided within ourselves and amongst ourselves. And this is where things get interesting. James says, "You do not possess because you do not ask." Asking is about prayer. So James is saying, you don't find peace in your hearts or peace in your relationships because you're not even asking God for it. We want something, we need something, but we never even ask. Or, James says, you do ask, but you do not receive because you ask wrongly, to spend it on your own passions. James is saying you're praying for the wrong things. You're just asking God to give you what you want. Now, it's not bad to pray for what you want. That's good. But I think there's a little more to it. Another step. When it comes to our pain, we often ask God to just take our pain away, to just make it disappear. Even Jesus asked God to spare him from the pain of the cross. But our prayer to God can't stop there, because Jesus' prayer didn't stop there. He said, "Father, if you are willing, take this cup away from me. Still, not my will, but yours be done." Sometimes people pray really vaguely, "God, your will be done." And it sounds holy and impressive, but it's a deeply challenging prayer to pray authentically. Because my way is my way for a reason. I think it's the best way. But James says, submit yourselves to God. Pray knowing that God will answer your prayer in a way that is in your long-term, eternal best interest. Then James comes to the main point of prayer. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. The point of prayer is not about getting what we want or manipulating God to give us what we want. God, take away this pain, heal me, free me. God, bring back life as we knew it in 2019. Bring back my spouse. Bring back, well, you fill in the blank. The point of prayer isn't about getting God to give us something. even things he surely wants for his children, like healing and wholeness. The point of prayer is drawing closer to God so we can hear his voice and follow him. Because it's possible that God wants to do something more than just take away the pain you're experiencing. So what should you do with your pain? Exactly as James said, draw near to God. First, talk to God about it. Whatever pain you're experiencing, have you brought it before God in prayer, specifically? Bring it to God. He knows about it, of course, but he longs to hear from you. Because your pain is exactly where God wants to meet you. And if we want God to heal it, we have to reveal it. So reveal it. Draw near to God in prayer. Tell God about the pain you're dealing with. Second, be open to God's will in the midst of your pain. Be curious. This isn't easy to do, but it opens us up to profound transformation. God, what are you up to in this situation? How do you want to transform me in the midst of my pain? How are you using this circumstance in my life to help me grow as a follower of Jesus? As a person, as a husband or wife, as a friend, as a sibling, as a student, as an employer, as a friend. Prayer. It sounds so obvious, and yet sometimes we show up to our relationship with God the same way we show up to that 3-second greeting with a neighbor. How are you? I'm fine. And we move on quickly. But the truth is, I'm not fine, and neither are you. Your Heavenly Father wants you to experience healing, wholeness, and transformation in the midst of your pain. It starts with being honest, by drawing close to God in prayer.
Let's profess our faith together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
With openness to God's healing presence, let's pray for the needs of our community and of our world.
For a spirit of welcome and hospitality in our church, that all who join us may experience God's love and a warm welcome. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering from natural disasters, especially all who have suffered losses through Hurricane Ida, the earthquake in Haiti, recent flooding and wildfires, that God will protect them from further harm and sustain all who are helping. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For refugees and displaced persons, especially those fleeing Afghanistan, for safety, protection, and welcome in new communities, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As a new school year begins, we pray for a safe return to the classrooms, for the health of students, teachers, and school staff. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic, for healing for all who are ill, and for strength and courage for all medical personnel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for those who died on September 11th, 2001, and for all who have died, that God will give them eternal peace and heal the grief in hearts that miss them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of all people, strengthen us by the answers to our prayers, to see others as you see them, and to extend your love and mercy to all. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
At this time, we invite you to participate in our offertory. Your giving supports New Roads and the amazing things God is doing in and through our church. The easiest way to make a gift is to text New Roads, all one word, to the number 202-858-1233. When you text us, you'll get a link sent back to give online via credit card, Venmo, PayPal, Apple Pay, or Google Pay. Again, to give, simply text New Roads, all one word, to the number 202-858-1233. Thank you for your support.
Stop breaking.
Our gifts are prepared, so I invite you to pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what we profess with devotion and faith may be ours through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, and all your holy people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Luke, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Joining our hearts and our voices, let's pray together with longing for the coming of God's kingdom.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your friends, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer one another a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Of the goodness of God.
of your voice. You've led me through the fire in darkest night. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I will live in the goodness of God.
Pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew by our worship, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you so much for joining us for worship today. It's always so great to be with you. We love you so much. Have a great week.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every prayer that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I'm gonna sing.